Steve Dotto here. How much time do you think you spend correcting your typing on a daily basis? I know I spend a lot, or used to spend a lot, because I learned to type a little later in life, and my typing skills are somewhat lacking. But it's amazing how consistently I make the same mistakes, transposing letters or the same spelling mistake over and over again. I'm remarkably consistent. So I went about looking for a tool that would help me. Rather than learning to type correctly and developing the actual skill, I looked for technology to help me, and I found it. This is a life-changing piece of software. In fact, I kind of get a little bit choked up when I think about it. It's called TextExpander. It is basically a keyboard macro tool. What it does is it looks for the string of characters that we type, and as we type it, and if it recognizes a certain string, it replaces that text with what we want to put in place. For example, I often do that letter transposition when I'm typing. Instead of typing the as T-H-E, I do the T-E-H all the time. So take a look here on the screen and watch with me in amazement as I type T-E-H, and then normally we'd have to go back and correct it, correct? Watch, I'm going to hit the H. What? Did you see that? It automatically changed it. Yes. Well, does it work for other things? Perhaps it does. Let's try can, C-N-A. What? It did it again. TextExpander is awesome. Now, it does correct little typos like this. It corrects common spelling mistakes, but you can also use it to insert common phrases like your address or your name or your email address, things that you put in on an ongoing basis. You basically program them as little macros. So for example, if you were a tech support person and you were constantly wrote the same phrase in emails or in correspondence to ask people to restart their modem, what you can do with TextExpander is put in, like, I'm going to put in colon restart, and it then replaces that with the text that you want to use over and over again. It's a terrific little tool. Let me show you the control area. I'm going to open it here. And actually, here, let's stay in the menu for a second. And you can see that we've got, they're called snippets, is what they call each of the little phrases that are there. And you can, I've got a folder here that I made for my mistakes. These are kind of default snippets for putting in things like your address. And then you can download other things like proper accents. You can download a library of accents. I have downloaded a library here of common spelling mistakes that people have, and it also has those typing transpositions that are common. But if you have a new one, anytime that you have a problem, you can create a new snippet yourself, or a new opportunity. If you're going to be typing the same phrase over and over again, you can create the snippet just from a selection or from your clipboard, or type it in. And where you manage it all, now let's take a look at the management tool here, is in the text expander window here. And you can see basically it's just a library of different common character strings that we're going to put in. So for example, I often type today's wrong with the, this is the other thing that I do, is watch, let me move that down, and I'm going to type into here today's, and I always hit the colon instead of the apostrophe. That's the common mistake that I make over and over again. It's where I put my fingers. So when I type in today, and then I hit the colon S, it then replaces it with the correct spelling. So that's the kind of just really benefit that I get. So in the past, after I type, because I'd be madly typing away, and I tend to look at my keyboard more than I look at the screen as I'm typing, and then I'd go back and I'd proofread. If I missed a mistake, then I'm just embarrassed because I send out something wrong. But then after all this time I spend writing, I got to spend time going through and cleaning up my document. TextExpander is just a great option for that. Now, it is not an inexpensive tool. It costs, for the basic version, it costs $35. And then if you want to buy the family pack, which will allow you to install, I think, on 5 computers, it's $46. I don't normally heartily endorse you getting and paying this much money for any simple utility. But this one here, I without any hesitation at all, I recommend it. Here, try me. Ask me, say, Steve, do you recommend we buy TextExpander for Mac? Yes, I do. See, no hesitation whatsoever. If you are a Windows user, they have a tool called Phrase Express, which does most of the same things. In fact, you can even import the libraries from TextExpander. So our Windows brethren are not left out. I haven't tested this program, but it probably works just about as well. And it's cheaper. I think it's free for the most part. But this is the best $35 to $45 you can spend. I hope you've enjoyed your time with us. Hey, I haven't mentioned it recently, But, you know, we do a podcast. We do a weekly radio show up here in Canada, and it's podcast each week on our site. And if you drop by, well, let's put it up there, dottotech.com. Let's see if I can spell it in right. There we go. At dottotech.com. And there we have each week's show available to you. Sorry. I haven't upgraded Drupal. That's why you see the little thing there. But what did we talk about this week? We talked about social sporting sites, Salesforce, and Pogo plugs. Fascinating stuff. I hope you've enjoyed this. Drop by again next time, and we will give you more productivity tips. I'm Steve Dotto. Thanks for spending time with me today.